Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I want to chat about journaling. This is something that I am so passionate about, and I've talked about it before on my channel, but I wanted to do kind of like a deeper dive into the three techniques that I love and use the most. I'm sure a lot of you know about the benefits and the importance of journaling, but maybe you're motivated to do it, but then you get there and you sit down with your pen and paper in front of your laptop and you just don't know what to write. So I hope that this video is going to be helpful, give you some good tips, and if you enjoyed this video, then we can definitely do more on this topic because I think it's really cool and it's something that's just genuinely helped me a lot in my life. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. So first we'll talk about the three main techniques that I really love, and then after that I'll share some of my like general tips that just help to kind of get me in the mood, set the tone, and some general kind of like advice around that. So the way that I like to do it is I like to divide my journal into different parts, and you can do this even if you don't have like this kind of spiral system. You can do it in any notebook. You just kind of pick different chunks of your notebook and you can write a title and the first page, and then depending on how you want to write that day, you have a designated section for that. So it just kind of stays a little bit more organized and in flow, and if you want to go back and find something, then you can easily do that. So the first part of my journal, this I have talked a little bit about in previous videos, but I'll just kind of skim over it quickly. This is not really a style, but this is more of these kind of like introductory pages that I love to flip through in the morning. For instance, I have my goals written down here. I have some vision boards. I have my morning and evening routine written out. I also really recommend to have a page in the front of your journal that describes the best version of you. So what is like you 2.0? What is the big, bold, best version of yourself? You could put a picture of yourself from a time where you felt really good, and you could describe like how you were feeling and maybe some notes on how you are when you are your best self, how you show up in the world, what kind of job are you doing, how are your relationships, how do you deal with challenging times, you know, things like that that kind of just put you in focus, because I think it's very easy to compare ourselves to other people and say like we want to be like that, but what we really want to be is the best version of ourselves. So I think it's really nice to just have a page or two or three. It's your journal, you can really make it whatever you want, but having something that is kind of like your North Star that you can refer to and just feel really inspired by when you look at it. So that's kind of like the first part of my journal. I guess that's almost like a journaling technique in itself, but that's something that I like to just kind of flip through in the morning. You could also have a page of quotes or pictures that inspire you, people that inspire you, you know, whatever kind of gets you going. And then we get to the first kind of journaling technique, and I call this kind of like the free flow style of journaling where you're really expressing yourself. This is really where I'm writing like an entry to myself. So if I feel like I have a lot on my mind, if I'm feeling really emotional, if I'm feeling confused, if I just need to get clarity and literally feel like I need to like wring myself out of my emotions, my feelings, this is the kind of style that I will normally gravitate towards. It's just a very free-flowing style of writing where you're not really thinking, you're just literally expressing yourself, getting everything that's going on in your mind out and onto a piece of paper, and it's so therapeutic. And there's something just very comforting about writing this way, because when I do write this way and when I write in general, I feel like it's a moment where you can really connect with yourself and you can really connect to your higher self, especially when it's early in the morning and it's very quiet. There's just a really calm and balanced energy, and I think that really helps to get us in tune and in check with ourselves. And what I often find is I'll start by writing something, like say I have something on my mind that's maybe bothering me, or just something emotionally, or I don't even have to be bothered by anything. Like it can just be something that I'm thinking about. It could just be an idea that I maybe want to explore further that I've been thinking about. And I feel like I'm a very deep thinker, and sometimes I can get kind of stuck in my head and like on a repeat circle. But when I journal and I can ask myself questions and I can follow that, it's actually really interesting what can come up. And it's a very, again, like self-soothing practice, because I feel like you start to kind of give yourself advice and your higher self starts speaking to you. And it's really incredible. Like, it gives me goosebumps thinking about all the times that I've written about something and then what's shown up on the page is so special and so beautiful and just like the perfect thing that I needed to hear. And that would have only happened if I continued to write and if I sat down there, because sometimes in our mind, like I said, we can kind of get stuck. We have like one thought, then another thought comes after that, and then it goes into a loop. So it's kind of like stuck. But I feel like when we write and we let that thought, instead of going like this, it can go like that and then go somewhere here. And this style of journaling has just shown me how much knowledge we all have inside of us. I know that we tend to look outside for information and guidance and help, which is also great and definitely has its place. But it's so important to turn inwards and not underestimate how much you already know. Sometimes in our mind we get stuck, but when we can express ourselves and when we can follow that thought and be curious, and if we had a loved one or a friend that was dealing with a similar issue or came to you for advice on something, what would you tell them? Like, truly, honestly, what would your advice be? Or if they just ask for your opinion on something, it doesn't have to be a problem, it can just be like something neutral, then what would you say to that? And that, I think, when you allow yourself to open up your mind and to be curious, be open, that's really when you can connect and when you can really like get so much gold out of your time journaling. I'm just looking through some of my old entries, and some of them is just nice to kind of see what was going on in my life at that time. So it's also a great memory to have. And it also just shows a lot of self-growth. You know, some of the things that I was writing about then, right now, I'm no longer dealing with. I've learned a lot of things since then. And that is really, really cool to see, because I think that often we kind of just move forward, which is a good thing, but it's really nice to kind of look back and see how far you've come, how much you've grown, special moments that happen as well, and again, just to have that as a memory. So that's like my kind of longer written things where I just like write free-flowing. The second style I really love is to recap a part of a book that I'm reading or a podcast that I listen to and just note down what I learned from that podcast, or again, from a book that I was reading, or even just like a talk that I was having, just writing information down that you've learned. For me, this is really powerful because I love listening to podcasts, I love reading, I love listening to audiobooks, and there are often so many things that I hear that I want to implement into my life, but then I'll go on to the next podcast or I'll continue reading in the book and then I'll kind of forget about that lesson or that piece of information. And yes, podcasts and books are great for inspiring you and for bringing about positive energy into your life, but it's another thing when we're actually really using those techniques and those lessons in our actual lives. A big way for me to actually remember and to integrate these things into my life is to write them down. So what I do is just write down the title of either the podcast or the book or the chapter of the book, and then I'll just do a few bullet points of things that I learned and also how I can implement them in my life and when. That way you really make it more likely that you're going to use and implement these techniques. Plus, it's really cool to just flip through these pages and get little snapshots of different valuable tips and information and takeaways that you got from different podcasts and books and conversations with people. So it's really cool to just look at this like zoomed out and see like over the last few weeks all the things that you learned, all the great information that you heard. You know, sometimes I'll be on a walk and I'll be listening to a podcast or an audiobook and I don't have my journal there. So I'll just take out my phone. I'll just open the Notes app on my phone and write down a few words that will help me to remember, or I will screenshot my screen where I'll have the timestamp of the podcast or the audiobook so that I can go back to it the day after in the morning, or go to my notes and see the words that I wrote down that will just help me to remember, and then I'll journal about it. And then the third form of journaling that I really, really love, I call this kind of like priming my brain or priming my energy for the day. This is a quick page of prompts that I have pre-written. It takes me just a few minutes to go through it. It's very simple, it's really easy. It's especially nice for mornings where I don't have a lot of time, but I still want to journal something. And this really makes you feel so good. It's such a nice way to direct your energy and to kind of set up your brain in the morning. I have a page here in the front of this section and it says, energy flows where attention goes. And I 100% believe that. I feel that so deeply. So I wanted to have that quote in the beginning. And I also just really love the actual picture. I think it's really nice. So I got inspiration for these prompts from a few different places. I'll pop in a picture here of a few of the different journals that I've had in the past and just some things that I've seen online that I found really inspiring and that I wanted to kind of make my own. And this is something that I think is really important to do as well, is to tailor these things for you. We might have different areas of our lives that we're trying to work on or nurture more. And for some people, it might be more personal things. For others, it might be more work-related. It could be self-care related. It could be related to relationships. And with this, you can really customize it to what you need. Whereas if you were to buy a planner or a pre-written notebook or something like that, it would still be really great. But with this, you're just personalizing it a little bit more to your life, which I really love. So the first section I have is grateful for, and there I will write three things that I'm really, really grateful for, and they can be as broad or as specific as I'm feeling that day. I will usually write something that I'm really grateful that I get to do that day, so something that I'm looking forward to, that I'm excited for. The next point I have is move the needle, and for me, this is something that I need to do that could be a bit challenging or that I've kind of been maybe putting off, or something that just requires me to really step out of my comfort zone. When I'm filling out this page, I also have my laptop, which I have right here. And there I have my to-do list with all of my goals for the day, things I have to get done, different projects I'm working on. I just prefer to do this digitally, but if you would wanna have something in here, you know, where it says like your top three goals for the day, you can again definitely customize that to make it work for you. But I prefer to have that in my computer, and then I will also make notes within my calendar, which is also on my computer. So the next section is I want to feel. So this, I love this section so much. So this is really like you are telling yourself and you are creating the mood for the day. How do you want to feel? Depends on what you have going on that day, whether it's a Monday, maybe then you want to feel really motivated, confident, strong, forward-thinking, inspired, you know, different things like that. But maybe if it's the weekend, you might want to feel relaxed and centered. So that kind of changes on the day and what I have going on that day. But I really love this because when I'm writing this down, I'm literally feeling that in my body. You could even set up a notification in your phone that could go off at like 12 o'clock and 3 o'clock in the afternoon, reminding you of those three words that you wanted to feel that day. Maybe just in the beginning until you kind of get the hang of this and it starts to really implement itself in your life, like automatically. So the next section is I am, and these are three different affirmations that I will write. Again, this is really for you to customize depending on your day, how you're feeling, what you need to hear. Again, just really bringing in that positive energy, priming your mind, directing yourself on where you want to go, how you want to feel. That's also very powerful. The next section is send love to. I actually had a similar one in my January self-care journal where I had social. This is my self-care journal, by the way. I'll have the video that I did on this linked down below if you guys want to check it out. But in there, I used to do things like a few times per week that were, you know, special, like little reminders and things that I could do for my loved ones, especially now that we're all in quarantine and we don't get to see each other as often. I think it's still really nice to keep that connection with people. The next section is yesterday's wins. I really, really love this, and I think it's very important because I'm the kind of person that is like, I will do lots of things, accomplishing things that I have set for myself, goals, to-do lists, things like that, and then I'm kind of on to the next. And for me, I found that it's really nice to take a moment and actually integrate those things and really think about like, wow, I did that. Have that moment to just be thankful for yourself, for your body, for your mind, your intellect, your perseverance, your discipline, and all of that. And again, these can be work-related or personal-related, anything that you've done that you feel proud of yourself for. I think it's important for our confidence as well to just give ourselves a pat on the back and know that we are heading the right way, even if it's not something that, like for me, that doesn't come easy, but it's something that I've really enjoyed doing as part of my journaling. And then the last part I have here is today's message. And this is a little message to myself. It could be a quote, even just telling myself something nice and uplifting for the day. And that's it for this page. And I love how simple it is, but it really makes me feel great in the morning. And again, it just really primes my brain, my energy. Next, I want to share a few of my tips when it comes to journaling, just in general. So I really find it helpful that I have everything set the night before. So before I go to bed, I'll make sure that my desk is clean and that I have my journal and my books and anything else that I need kind of ready for when I wake up, because the last thing I want to do when I wake up is spend time cleaning. And my brain just works a lot better when things are organized and clean and just more inspiring to be in. I also love to set the mood. I like to light a little candle. I'll usually also have a tea as I'm writing. If you're new to journaling, I also recommend to set an amount of time that you want to be writing. So it could be either 10 minutes, 20 minutes, 30 minutes, depending on how much time you have. You can just set a timer on your phone and you will write for that amount of time, because I think it's very easy to, depending on the person, but if you're completely new to this, you might put your pen to paper and just feel like you don't know what to write, and maybe you feel discouraged and you give up and you just think like, okay, I'm just gonna go on to the next thing. But if you know that you have like an allotted 20 minutes and there's nothing else that you need to do for that 20 minutes except write, it kind of takes the time pressure off of things, and you'll probably be surprised at what you can write in just such a short amount of time. With that said, I also think it's really important to tailor this to your lifestyle and to what's possible for you. The worst thing would be like, well, I don't have 20 minutes every single morning to journal, and that's okay. These are tools that you can use when you feel like you need them. It doesn't have to be an every morning kind of thing. It shouldn't feel like something you have to do. It's something that you should crave doing when you need it. For some people, doing it every morning as a routine, as a habit, could be great. But if that just doesn't work for you and for your lifestyle, that's okay too. You could just use this and have this in your toolbox of things to use when you need it. It should feel inspiring and fun and therapeutic and not something that's like a chore for you to do. So just keep that in mind as well. So those are a few of the topics that I wanted to cover in this video. Let me know if you guys found this video interesting, and if you want me to share more of my journaling techniques, things that really work for me, or things that I've just learned through my journaling past, let me know below if that's something that you guys would want to see. Thank you so much for watching. I really hope that you enjoyed. I hope that you're all having a beautiful day, and I will see you in my next one. Bye guys.